How's it going, YouTube? This is Mitch Santona back with some weekend action. Now, welcome to my channel if you're new to it. Primarily, I'm a Transformer reviewer guy, but on the weekends, I like to delve into some other stuff. Primarily, some cool things that I found at the store, some cool things I own, some cool vintage stuff, and just in general, action figures and toys that I find are interesting. And this toy line, this Wave 1 of the Pirates of the Caribbean, so on Stranger Tides toy line, which has come out recently, has intrigued me. So, titles aside, what we have are the action figure line is by Jack's Pacific, and it's and these are kind of cool figures. They look cool, at least in the box. I haven't taken any of them out of the box yet, but I'm going to do that, and then the second part of the review, I'll have everything out. In particular, the first wave, if you look on the back, let me see if I can focus here. It comes with Angelica, which is Penelope Cruz's character. Blackbeard, Jack Sparrow, Barbossa, and Gibbs. We know the other characters. Blackbeard's a new character as well. And I think he's the main villain. But I'm not sure what Barbossa's deal is now. I'll get to him when I get to him. But all of the figures, the normal figures all come in packaged like this. And it's like about anywhere from about an $8 to $9 price point. And they come small, and they all come with accessories. Now, Angelica, in particular, she comes with this ring, and all the accessories light up with a black light, so you can shine it on their face. Let me see if I can get it close to... Nah, it's not going to focus. We'll do something about this lighting. Hold on one sec. I couldn't get Angelica to focus, but here's Gibbs. He came with a barrel, and then you do this, and it lights up. He's got like some tattoos. I'm not sure what this is supposed to represent. Now, if anyone knows anything about the story, which, you know, it's kind of hinted around at, the main thing is they're looking for the Fountain of Youth. I don't know if Jack Sparrow's looking for it, or they're... I don't know. I don't want to even speculate what the story is about. But I know that the Fountain of Youth has something to do with it. There's a lot of zombies that have something to do with it. And hopefully, when the rest of this waves come out of this toy line, we'll get some zombie figures and mermaids and whatever else they've been showing in the trailers. So, kind of excited to see that. All these small figure packages come with the accessory that lights up, and it gives them you know your tattoos that they're pretty much glow in the dark, but you can't see them during the day. And then they all come with pretty much all of them have their own hat. They got a little sword, and usually a couple of pistols as well. Now, in addition to the smaller boxes, I picked up Gibbs and Angelica in these the smaller packs. Now, he comes with his little barrel. Same thing, he comes with a sword. Looks like, I don't know if he's got a hat. I don't think Gibbs ever wore a hat that I can recall, but he's got a pistol as well. And the same packages in the back. Now, what I was saying about picking up, they have larger price packs as well. Now, these are a little bit bigger and they come with accessories. The accessories are for something else. It's for another item. It's actually Queen Anne's Revenge, which is his ship. Which is a very, very cool thing. Now, they have Blackbeard, they have Barbossa, and they also have Jack Sparrow in the smaller items, in the smaller packages, if you don't want all the accessories or if you don't plan on getting the pirate ship. And they actually come with different, accessories as well. Now, he's got a coin that he comes with, but I think in his deluxe version, he comes with something different. And I can't offhand remember what it is. I know one of them came with a bottle. It may have been him. Like a bottle of rum, which is kind of cool. I almost want to go back and get that because I think that's cool. But this version here comes with a couple of cannons that fire. He's got like a coin, and you know he lights up as well. It's hard to see with this lighting. Comes with a hat, a sword, his little pistol as well. And it shows everything that they come with on the bottom. If you look, even on the small pieces, the instructions have it on the bottom what they all come with. So that's a little look at Blackbeard. We'll get him out of the box in a second. And we've got Barbossa, who now has a peg leg. I'm not sure why. I'm sure that's going to get explained in the new movie. And that's cool. He's on a little boat with like a net shooting gun. That's what that looks like there. And he's got a crutch for his peg leg. So I'm not sure how he lost that leg. I got to assume Blackbeard has something to do with it. And then here, last but not least, is Jack Sparrow, and he comes with like his own little paddy wagon. And he comes with a paddy wagon. He comes with a lantern, which is part of the pirate ship as well. And he's got his signature hat and his pistol and his sword
and
as well.
Very, very cool. I like the look of these guys. I'm going to break them on open, and we'll check them out in hand and see what they look like.
Okay, so let's start off with Angelica. Angelica comes with, first off, she comes with this accessory, which is a ring, which could be worn. I can't wear it just because my hands are huge. So in a child's hands, this will fit. And you can go around and buzz people like Green Lantern. That is a black light, and that was very bright. Very cool. Well, special effect there. Let's look at Angelica. Now, you can use the power ring, and you can see I'm having problems getting her to light up. This is supposed to be secret reveal technology that says it reveals some secret tattoos. I don't know really what that means. I don't know what correlation that has to the movie. I'm not going to reveal all of these on this video. I may, at the end, put some reveal shots when I get it all done. But as of right now, I'm just going to show you this. She has the tattooing. She comes with a removable, it's kind of a rubbery. All of the accessories are all really rubbery. Now, this isn't really meant for a small child just because there are choking hazards. These guns, even the small little guns, are kind of rubbery. But they all have these little pirate guns. She does not have a place to store her little gun, unfortunately. Some of the other figures do. Her hat comes off. It's removable. It's kind of cool. It's rubbery. And the sword can come off, too. And all of their swords are customized to their, to their on-screen iterations. I apologize for the throat clearing. Oh, that will come out of this little scabbard that it comes with. So that's cool. But very, very soft. I mean, this is just really, really soft. I mean, it's just not dangerous at all. It's dangerous to swallow, but you couldn't poke anything with this, I don't think. So that's really her little list. She's got this little strap here with the sheath, if you will. And this can come off as well. But these figures are pretty detailed. Let me get it up close here. Okay, so I don't know how much of a likeness this is to, like, Penelope Cruz. I guess it's okay. But a lot of detail has been put into these figures. So I can appreciate it for that. Down to the material, and the way the material flows looks pretty natural. It looks pretty cool. Really do like the fact that you can kind of, you know, they've gone in and they've sculpted in, like, all this. I don't know if it's molded, sculpted, or what, but, you know, you can see the buttons and the just the buckles and just some of the ornate workings, like, on the belt, on all of these, like, clasps and such. So, very cool. She's got some nice little boots on her here with the heels, and you can see the just the wrinkles and the leather and stuff. So, these are very detailed figures. Posability, I'm not real crazy about all these. I'm not going to go through all these just on this one, but they can turn their heads a little bit. They're all pretty much kind of hindered by whatever kind of hair or hat accessories they have. So this is like a rubbery one piece her hair is. These all can swivel at the arm, and they have a bend at the arm, and the hands can swivel, which is nice. I do enjoy that. I like that. But there's no ball joint, so you can't really pull the arms off the side. And that's not too bad, except when you get to Barbossa, and I'll show you that in a sec. Yeah, same with this. And they all come with a kind of a shooting grip and like an open-handed grip. You can put the sword. You can get the sword and the gun to fit in either hand. The guns don't fit really well on this. It's more for this side. But the sword I've got to fit in either hand. And the legs don't have any kind of ball joints at all. They just have one bend at the knee and that's it. There's nothing at the ankle. There's nothing at the hips. There's nothing at the waist. So I'm not real big fan of the posability. I'm kind of spoiled with some of the newer figures and how flexible they are with the mid-waist and ball joints everywhere. But these are very detailed, so I can't complain about that. Let's move on to Gibbs. So, Gibbs is pretty cool. He comes with his barrel, and the barrel does the reveal on him. I rather like Gibbs' tattoos. It looks like a skull face. He's one of the cooler tattooed guys. The barrel will match the woodwork of the Queen Anne's Revenge, which is Blackbeard's ship. And we'll set that aside right now. He comes with his little pistol, which he can kind of hold. You got to kind of wedge it in there. You can get it to stay stiff, but it does like to pop out. So we'll get rid of that. His little bandolier here, it holds his sword as well. That, you know, that can come loose. This whole thing can come off, and his blue vest can come off too. So a lot of little pieces to lose on these guys.
But everything's really, really, really rubbery and soft. So that's kind of cool. So same posability as the last one, but let's get that headshot here. And I think this is a really good likeness of Gibbs. I think that's a very good head sculpt. It looks very true to the on-screen character. And I do dig this guy. Barbossa. Now, Barbossa has some hit and misses. He's got the most, like, big accessories. I mean, he comes with a boat. He comes with a little small lifeboat. He comes with a net shooting gun, which this can be mounted on the small lifeboat. And the small lifeboat is one of the Queen Anne Revenge's accessories as well. You can stick this in the top of this, and it does this, and there's a little, you know, there's a button, it'll shoot, doesn't fire very hard, it's very kind of a weak spring, but he does come with a boat, and then this will hook to Queen Anne's Revenge as well. There's also a post here for an extra mast that you can take off the Queen Anne Revenge's poop deck and plug it in right here. So that's kind of cool. You can give it its own little, like, sail mast. We get this aside here. It comes with this pretty interesting coin. I don't know how relevant this is going to be to the movie. It's got a castle, a couple of lions, another castle here. And it's got some foot pegs. And there's a receptacle here for a post on the Queen Anne Revenge's deck for where he could fight. And, of course, it's got the... you know, the black light action when you push the button, if you can push it hard enough. And there we go. Again, you know, he's got the tattoos as well. They're not really coming out. Some of them have tattoos all over their bodies. Some of them just in the face. But I'm not going to really reveal all that. Now, he comes with a crutch and a peg leg. Again, I don't know how he lost his leg. I don't know if we're going to see him lose his leg or if it's just something that's going to have happened off screen or throughout the years, and he's going to say, oh, you know, I lost it to Blackbeard, the most feared pirate, blah, blah, blah. One little downfall about this, because he doesn't have a shoulder joint, you can't really pull his arm off, and I don't want to wedge his crutch underneath there, because it'll really just bend the crutch up, or I'll really just end up jacking the shoulder right out of the socket, so that's not cool. His sword also came in a little bit, so that was kind of crappy too. Now, the downfall is to Barbossa. His hat doesn't come off. It's just, it's all on there. You can't have that come off if you wanted it. And he doesn't have anywhere to store any of his stuff. Like the crutch, the sword, there's no little holds or slits where he can, like, kind of slide it back into some of his clothes or whatever, like the other characters do. So, but very cool figure. This guy's got a great likeness. Let me see if I can zoom this here. I like this, the likeness of this one as well. I think it looks pretty good. This actually looks better because I've seen pictures of him from the new trailer, and he looks pretty scrubby. They got him up pretty good. His hair is just all gnarly looking, and he's got this nice coat on. So, still looks like a pirate, even though he's decked out in the East India. I think it's East Indian Trade Company. I can't remember what the name of it was. I'll post it if I said it wrong. All right, so here's Blackbeard. Blackbeard also comes with the coin. It's the same coin. Whoops. It's not any different than Barbossa's. It's got the lions and the castles on it. I'm not sure if that's the East Indian Trade Company's logo. I haven't looked that up. It probably is. But again, it doubles as a stand. You know, these don't really stand well. You're gonna have a hard time standing them up, just because their lack of posability. Some will be better than others, I imagine. Not even really on a level surface, but these coins will help that because they have peg heels. They have holes in their heels, and then they'll just peg in like so. Now, Blackbeard had his hat just fall off. That's a removable accessory on him, which is cool. I like the ones that have the hats that come off. I think that's cool. But this guy's got a lot of detail. Now, he's got a little slit in his rubbery outfit here that you can tuck the gun in. Now, this comes off. He can hold it just like everybody else. He also came with a scabbard. Now, interesting here, another maybe a story plot point, I'm not sure, but they did manage to detail this in, so I have to imagine it has some relevance. His scabbard is chewed away. That's not like a faulty mold or anything. Let me see if I zoom in this. So it's purposely chewed away there, and there's a little bit of the exposed sword. Now, his sword, when you pull it out, it's like the tip of it's chopped off. I don't know if that is relevant to the story. Maybe it is. Maybe it's just a little quirk of his character. I'm not sure. But we'll take it out. This guy really is cool looking. He's pretty menacing. He's got the braided beard, pretty pretty cool in all of his black garb. I really do like the look of this, and I like the look of the dude in the movie that plays him too. And of course the cannons can be used on the Queen Anne's Revenge. Okay, so this leads us to our hero, Captain Jack Sparrow, who comes with his very own paddy wagon. I'm sure at some point he gets captured and put into this sucker. It's got the old wagon wheels here, rivets all over the side. You can see the bars in there, and you can see through it. It's, you know, he's got the opening doors, and you can store a figure in there if you choose. He will fit inside of here. Very cool. There's a place for this on the ship as well, so that's another interactive feature to have. He comes with a lantern, which is, I guess, the main lantern that hangs on the pirate ship as well. And that lights up. And Captain Jack's got all kinds of tats on him. He's got his whole body is pretty much full of them. They're not really coming out really well because this one doesn't shine as bright or as direct as the other ones. You gotta be in a darker room, and I got my lights on right now for the camera. But Jack Sparrow's pretty sweet. He's got all the little details. I'm not sure how much like Johnny Depp that looks. Let's see if we can get to focus. There's his face. He's looks like he may be a little bit drunked up on rum or something, but it's not too bad. It's not too bad. A lot of detail in these figures, and I do like that. Even like the material of his vest and such. It's still that rubbery material, but it's got a lot of nice little intricacies that they bothered to take, and I like that about this. Just the buckle work and all of his belts and the leather work and everything. There's his compass. That's cool. Shrunken head. I imagine that's his mother. I think that's a plot point as well in the new movie, if you remember the last one. I don't even know what I'm looking at here. It looks like a little rabbit's foot, and the gun does come off of this one. That's what you get. You get a little hole there for it, and then you can plug it right in. And it's a rubbery little gun too, just like the rest of them. His sword as well. Nothing special. His sword was one of the straighter ones, but it's also one of the softer ones, I noticed. I don't know why. All the way down to his little boots and his little pirate boots, and this dude is pretty cool. I like Captain Jack quite a bit. He's a nice looking figure in his infamous hat, and it's cool the way the hat fits on him too. I think it looks nice. It looks proportionate. Doesn't look like way out of line. I mean, that's the way it looked in the movie. So a very cool figure. So I was gonna try to do this all in one shot. I don't think I'm gonna be able to. I think it's gonna be way too long of a review, but I do have another little surprise as the end of this review here. And this thing is awesome.